Hello and welcome to day one here at the Biotech Showcase in San Francisco. I'm Christine Corrado with Proactive. Joining me right now is Sergey Jakimov. He's the co-founder of Longenesis. Sergey, it's great to meet you.
Great to be here.
From my understanding, you're developing a data sharing platform among healthcare institutions. First off, tell me about the company.
Right. So as Longenesis, we were founded in Hong Kong in 2017, and that started off for us from our relationship with Hong Kong Science Park. We're also powered by two slightly bigger corporates on our shareholding list. One of our co-founders is in Silicon Medicine, which is quite famous among the participants here in the conference, and they're a powerhouse for AI currently. And our second co-founder from the corporate is Bitfury, and Bitfury now happens to be one of the biggest full-service blockchain companies in the world. Yeah, they are a blockchain unicorn, which makes us pretty much tech-equipped, both data-wise and sort of technology-wise. Now, Longenesis focuses on one very simple yet not solved problem in pharma and then healthcare space, and that is enabling pharmaceutical companies that are usually the biggest clinical data consumers and hospitals and other sort of genome sequencers, et cetera, that are typically the biggest data aggregators to be able to talk to each other directly and essentially enable the data access between the two and the data sharing between the two, which sort of entails two problems, technically speaking. One is technology, and the other one is legislation. And Longenesis is the one solving, with its data platform and extendable toolkit solutions over this data platform, and we help hospitals and pharmaceutical companies to exchange data legitimately, equipping it with dynamic and digital patient consent, and though sort of stimulating more data flowing into clinical, preclinical research, patient recruitment, and what's more important, proactive studies with patients, which is the biggest value so you can get from clinical data.
Digital patient consent allows you to kind of get across the HIPAA compliant type of rules.
Correct. We've spent the last year pretty much in tailor fitting our tools that we deploy with hospitals, consent among them, so we have our custom consent module, to be fit to essentially work with any other data privacy regulation around the world. That is HIPAA. HIPAA is, by the way, not the most difficult one.
No.
HIPAA is pretty pretty forgiving. What's not forgiving is GDPR in Europe, and Asian regulations are the harshest ones.
So
yeah, if you go for Korea, which is PIPA, that's the hardest one to comply with, and we've spent a lot of time actually doing it. So
how far are you in developing the technology?
Right. So right now we're basically, our core product is Longenesis Data Dashboard, which is the central tool that aggregates the metadata metrics from all the healthcare partner healthcare institutions that we have. That includes hospitals, private hospital chains, genome sequencers, et cetera. And the extendable toolkit that we deploy with these institutions individually so that they can actually pass the metadata metrics into our dashboard. From the other way, we already have pharmaceutical companies that are querying through the data and have the ability to directly request the access to these data items from the hospitals themselves or to the patients, so to the cohorts of their interest, for clinical trial recruitment, for any other proactive studies or any other data generation. So right now, our biggest footprint is Asia. We're very active in South Korea. We're expanding in Singapore. We're looking into China. We haven't started in China yet. It's very specific in terms of data regulation. We have a lot of stuff going on with oncology data, oncology-related data specifically in Northern Europe, with pretty much all the biggest oncology patient associations and hospitals that are dealing on this with this and on the state level. We already had several deployments in U.S. with U.S.-based partners, so I could fairly say that we're growing. It's, you know, we always want faster growth, of course.
Well, lots to look forward to in 2020.
That is something to look forward to, indeed.
Well, thank you so much for sitting down with me, Sergey.
Thank you so much.